Hi, this is Larry K with ShadowAnyone.com and the creator of the Investigator's Ultimate Guide series. I have also written the best-selling book, 51 Dirty Tricks Bad Guys Really Hate. So I want to talk today about a particular dirty trick, and that is whether or not it's okay as a private investigator to set up a guy to test his fidelity. So here's the situation. A woman will call you and say she wants to know if her man cheats or not. And she wants you to use a female investigator to approach him in a bar, flirt with him, and see where it goes. Is that something that's ethical or not? The answer is no. I mean, I can unpack that a little bit for you if you like. No, it's not ethical at all. So some people will say, well, is it legal or not? And that's an entirely different question. Matter of fact, I tell you what, next week I'll do a video on legalities and things for you. But no, this idea of testing a man's fidelity by using a female operative, a female private investigator, seeing what he would do if he's approached, that's not ethical. Our job is to find the truth, and we don't meddle with our subject when we're making observations. There are things that we just don't do, a lot of things that we don't do. And so, for example, it would be completely, you got a workers' compensation case, and the person is not supposed to lift over 5 pounds. And how do you test this? How do it? You go out, you put a cinder block behind their car in their driveway, and you sit back and you record. When they come out, if they pick up that cinder block and move it, boom, I gotcha. You've lifted more than 5 pounds. Totally not ethical. Probably not even admissible. You may be liable for certain things, including, by the way, what if the person injures themselves moving this cinder block you put there? It's just ridiculous. We don't meddle with the subjects that we're watching. We want to get the truth. We want to get the unvarnished truth. So what's the difference between that and maybe the police department using female officers for a prostitution sting, to a reverse prostitution ring, as they might say, where you're trying to see if there are Johns or bust the Johns who approach prostitutes? Is it different? I would argue that it is. It's very different. One, legally speaking, and again, I'll do a video next week, legal, illegal, whatever, but the police have to deal with elements of what's called entrapment. Arguably, private investigators don't have to worry about that from a legal perspective, but you know, check with a lawyer if you have any questions. But what the police are doing is, generally, they will round up the prostitutes from a corner or a block or a stretch where they regularly, normally hang out, and they will put a decoy officer there, a female officer, to pose as a prostitute, and the men that come by are cruising for prostitutes. They are not taking female officers and putting them out in bars, approaching men and soliciting them for prostitution, those types of things. In fact, if you look at how these reverse stings run, the officer is not going to solicit the John, the subject of the investigation. He's the one that's going to come up and make all the moves. If these seem like subtle differences to you, okay, I get that. It can seem like a gray area, but when you delve into really what is true, what is right, these things become much more clear. Here's a takeaway: if you do nothing else, pre-decide. Think about these things ahead of time. Say to yourself, these are the types of cases I will not take, or these are the types of actions I will not do. At the very minimum, you should not be willing to do anything illegal. So there's, you've pre-decided. No matter what case you get, no matter how worthy the cause, no matter how much the victim needs quote-unquote justice from you, you cannot break the law to help the person in that way. If you pre-decide that now, it's going to help you immensely when the situation arises and there are emotions and feelings playing and tugging at you as well. Finally, something to consider is if you're a member of your state private investigator organization, they very well may have a code of ethics. Make sure you read it and understand it. By being a member of that organization, you have said that you agree to abide by that code of ethics. In my state, the code of ethics for my PI association specifically forbids using this type of operation where you'll send an operative or an undercover in to test the fidelity of the subject you're watching. Look, the reality is, if he's a cheater, then If you spend the time, the money, and the energy to find that out, you'll find that out. I understand that people are on a tight budget, that they want the quick way, but simply putting opportunity in front of him, and who knows how much that's encouraging or not encouraging. Maybe it's not something he would normally do, but when you present the opportunity, he seizes it and it's totally out of character for him normally. You're not getting an accurate representation of the truth in those circumstances. I'm not saying that it's right for him to say yes to the flirtations of an operative, but I am saying I don't believe it's right for you to put that operative out there to begin with. This is Larry K with ShadowAnyone.com. Remember, do the right thing, even if it's the hard thing.